好的，我们题目已经抽出来了，同学们也已经在准备室做准备了，我们计时开始。好的，马上就要来进行第二阶段的英语即席演讲比赛咯。马上进行第二阶段的英语即席演讲比赛，我们欢迎第一队上场。计时开始。
A group of Malaysian tourists who visited Taiwan made a video that went viral online. The video showed different beautiful aspects of Taiwan. For example, the perfect civic manners on the MRTs and the innovative cultural and creative industrial products we have. After watching the video, I learned that soft power is what really makes Taiwan shine. Honorable judges, ladies and gentlemen,Good afternoon. As you can see, soft power plays an important role in the country's world profile and is an essential element for us to promote Taiwan. For years, Taiwan has been active in developing its soft power and raising its world profile. In fact, there are two types of soft power that are perfect for Taiwan to utilize.In order to join international organizations to make the world understand Taiwan better. Now, my partners are going to elaborate more on these two types of soft power.
Thank you, Jason. Taiwan has the latest successful developments and accomplishments of using medical soft power to strengthen diplomatic ties with other nations. For instance,Early in 1999, Taiwan cooperated with 9 other Asian countries to set up a medical organization named AHWP, Asian Harmonization Working Party. This organization is devoted to studying and promoting the harmonization of medical laws. Clearly, the Taiwan medical technology, like combating the dengue fever,and being an expert in rare diseases has long been renowned in the international community. With this, we believe that Taiwan has enough abilities and experiences to join the WHO. Also, our ROC government has the same goal with WHO as well, and that is to build a better and healthier future for people all around the world. We believe thatJoining in WHO to promote Taiwan is not a dream, but a goal that we are approaching. Now, my partner William will talk about another soft power that we can utilize to promote Taiwan.
Thank you, Megan. Besides our medical soft power, agriculture is also an advantage for Taiwan to join international organizations in order to enhance our reputation.And let the world understand Taiwan better. Take APAARI, Asia Pacific Association of the Agricultural Research Institutions, for instance. One can provide practical support in agriculture to those in need. By joining it, Taiwan can not only share experience, publish books, and give a helping hand to those in need of professional training.In order to solve the problem of malnutrition and poverty. Taiwan, as the member of the Global Village, has already assisted many countries around the world. For instance, Taiwan has already sent professional teams to Kenya, Peru, and the Republic of Palau in order to promote our irrigation technology and rice planting. With the experience, we believe that joining the Food and Agriculture Organization,of the United Nations in order to enhance our reputation is not a dream, but a goal that we're approaching. By doing so, we believe that Taiwan can use our soft power to enhance ourselves and let the world know us better.
Exactly, William. Soft power is an important method for us to promote Taiwan and interact with other countries around the globe. Therefore, how to utilize soft power is a crucial issue we should think of. Through the Malaysian's video, we know that Taiwan is well known for our MRT etiquette, as well as cultural and creative industry. But our soft power of medical and agriculture are incredible too. As my partner just mentioned, our ROC government has joined the international organization, AHWP and APAARI. We not only give medical support and humanitarian aid to countries in need, but also offer agricultural help to others. By joining these international organizations, we can definitely polish up our nation's image and show our will to join WHO, FAO, and so on to make the world understand Taiwan better. By doing so, we, Taiwanese, can definitely
shine on the global stage.
Thank you, 接着欢迎第二队上台。计时开始。
Good afternoon.
If Taiwan is to stand on the international stage, we have to increase our country's soft power. Soft power, or the ability to attract and co-opt, rather than coerce using force or giving money. To shape the preferences of others is essential in making others want what you want. The soft power strategy is wide-ranging. It includes developing globally recognizable brands, boosting Taiwan's presence, not only in the high-tech sector, but also in arts, food, and fashion, and marketing the uniqueness Taiwan has to offer. If we take a close look to Taiwan's soft power strategy, it reveals three major components: promotion of domestic literature and book-related activities, creative culture, and quality tourism. We constantly strive for our integration into the international community, flexing our soft muscles to let the world know more about Taiwan. Here's Eva to tell you more.
Thank you, Amber. Taiwan's belief in the power of books is reflected in the many museums devoted to writers. We have a free and diverse creative environment with a thriving publishing industry that produces more than 40,000 books a year. We do believe that the more we read, the more we think and reflect, and the less depressed we are. In Taiwan, we teach our children the concept of lifelong learning, lifelong reading at a young age, because we believe in the power of books. Reading helps people invent and design. It is a basis of films, cartoons, and other media forms. A great example is director Ann Lee, who explores the conflicts and relationships between tradition and modernity, as well as Western and Eastern cultures through his movies. By promoting Taiwanese culture, literature, and language, we can help the international community understand Taiwan better. My friend Angel will tell you more.
Thank you, Eva. Taiwan is a dynamic environment for culture. The touristic features of our island need to be highlighted, like our street food and night market culture, as well as our ethnic diversity. We need people to know about the beautiful Taroko Gorge, the scenic East Coast, and the majestic mountains that make Taiwan a truly beautiful place. So, what we should do is to introduce Taiwan to the world. We can do this through social media, such as Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. So, the more tourists we have, the more information we can spread out to the world, and more of Taiwan will be recognized. After all, Taiwan is an amazing place worth knowing. Here's Tony to wrap it all up.
Thank you, Angel. We have to promote our cultural creativity. Creative design is the key to the improvement of national competitiveness. Our main mission is to elevate our creativity of Taiwanese designers, to promote international design exchanges, to improve our market competitiveness of Taiwanese industries, to help enterprises build up their own brands, and to tell the world that the era of design in Taiwan has come. We, the people of Taiwan, are exerting ourselves to display our soft power, and our efforts are bearing fruit. The number of tourists visiting Taiwan has more than tripled since 2002. Taiwan will have more presence on the world stage than ever before. We believe Taiwan's creativity and culture will surely help Taiwan be recognized in the global arena.
Thank you.
谢谢第二队。接下来欢迎第三队上台。计时开始。
Though Taiwan is a tiny spot on the world map, our influence is felt far beyond our borders, and many of our fellow countrymen are shining brightly in the international arena. Why?Because we have our unique characteristics embedded in our soft power. Honorable judges, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. With our vigor and potential, combined with our cultural creativity, we, Taiwan's new generation, boast the most influential soft power that boosts our international profile. In the preparation room, we came up with a creative ideato promote Taiwan through our dazzling GEM. You must be curious what our GEM, G-E-M, represents. First of all, let's welcome Max to tell us more. Max?
Thank you, Daniel. First of all, G stands for game, an online video game. I would like to create this game to introduce our soft power embedded in our inventions. Just a month ago,Taiwan was the brightest star at the Nuremberg Invention Exhibition by winning 18 gold medals. Some of our participants are still in middle school. Also, in the summer of 2014, 20 students from National Jiao Tong University impressed the world with a green building they designed in France called the Orchid House, a self-sustaining facility that uses green technology to alleviate climate change by reducing its carbon emissions.Inventions like these play a meaningful role in making our world a better place. So, in my online game, I will create a character of an inventor using our young people's inventions as weapons to fight against global issues like deforestation, climate change, or overfishing. Players will not only learn how these Taiwanese inventions work, but realize how to harness our soft power. What do you think, Fuki?
Thank you, Max.Sounds like an amazing idea. I would love to play that game. Secondly, E is for emoji. Personally, I love cooking. I think Taiwan's soft power also comes from our scrumptious cuisine. So I would like to design a series of emoji to illustrate mouth-watering delicacies, like beef noodles, mango-shaped eyes, or rice pyramids. I will first personify the dishes,by giving them different facial expressions. For example, it would be fascinating to see an oyster omelet with a cute little face saying, okay, good job, or take it easy. Moreover,
I would like to give each emoji a hyperlink, which connects it to a website that tells people more about the delicacy, like how to make it, where it originated from, and where to find it in Taiwan. By using these emojis to interact with our foreign friends on dozens of social media networks, we not only show the world our culture creativity, but also put our soft power to the best use. What do you think, Ashley?
Thank you, Fuki. Your emoji idea is really innovative. Lastly, M stands for microfilm. This film will follow us, the participants of this contest, as we demonstrate our soft power on the aspect of global vision in various ways. For example, this morning, we saw one team displaying cultural creativity by fusing traditional elements with contemporary dance. Another team, introducing Taiwanese culture in Vietnam with glove puppetry. And still another team, reminding the world to extend a helping hand to Syrian refugees through the YouTube. Meanwhile, our team also presented a story about two Taiwanese exchange students coming across foreign culture and came up with a virtual reality game to help enhance mutual understanding among people from around the world. By demonstrating the microfilm about this contest to our foreign friends, they will surely realize the soft power we Taiwanese team diplomats possess. Back to you, Daniel.
Thank you, Ashley. I really like your idea. Taiwanese young people have demonstrated various aspects of our soft power. And we like to promote Taiwan through our precious gem, in which G, referring to the online game, introduces Taiwanese youth's inventions. E, the emoji, illustrates Taiwan's mouth-watering cuisine. M, the microfilm, vividly shows how we Taiwanese young people harness our originality in solving global issues. Through the gem, we will not only display Taiwan's soft power, but also help Taiwan shine on the world map. Ladies and gentlemen, the world is getting smaller.
Let's dream bigger! Thank you!
谢谢第三队。接下来我们欢迎第四队上场。 计时开始。
Hello everyone, nice to meet you. You must have heard of the director Ann Lee. You must have also heard of the famous choreographer Xu Jiayi. And you have also heard of the Miami Marlin pitcher Chen Weiying. These superstars are all from the small island, Taiwan, which even cannot be found on the big world map. However, Taiwan has made an important influence on the whole world all the time. That's because Taiwan is a country of advanced technology, and Taiwan is a wonderland of freedom and democracy. As we know, Taiwan is a country denied by all the participation in international activities. So far, Taiwan is not a member of any UN-related organization. In spite of this, we need to do something to take a seat for us to make an importance of the world. But how? Just make our soft power.
Luckily, Taiwan's agriculture is well known around the world. After many years' research, we have a good harvest in some produce. Take orchids and tea, for example. The orchids of Taiwan Sugar Corporation is popular around the world. Every year in Taiwan, we held an international orchid show attracting orchid lovers from different countries, including Queen of the United Kingdom. As for tea, it's another pride of us. For a long time, Alishan Oolong Tea has been loved by the people all over the world. to our delight, nowadays Taiwan has beaten the India and Sri Lanka and won the fame of the Black Tea Kingdom. Furthermore, over years, our experts in agriculture has been to many developing countries, teaching people there how to improve their skills. By means of agriculture, we can definitely put Taiwan onto the global stage.
Probably, Taiwan has many hidden champions, and my tea made in Taiwan is a guarantee for a good quality. Now, let me introduce a source for you. As everyone knows, Taiwan is famous, is globally called ROC, meaning Republic of Computer. The president of Intel company, Andrew Gross, once said, if Taiwan stopped production, the industries of personal computer would become to the end. Here's another example, Giant. You must have ride a bike of Giant to travel around Taiwan, and I want to tell you that is the bicycle products of the Taiwan people is the biggest company of the in the world, and it's ranked top one of the world. Now, we have many attractive features, and what we can do and should do is just promote them and as possible as we can. That's because I believe that Taiwan youth has ability to do something to our country. Now, let me find a seat for Taiwan to go on the stage.
Warmly, Taiwan keeps reaching out to the countries in need. Whenever disasters like tsunamis and earthquakes occur, we are always ready to provide humanitarian assistance. For over 50 years, Taiwan have been actively providing humanitarian relief, including agriculture training support, vocational training, and medical service. By means of giving a lending hand, we can definitely find a seat for Taiwan on global stage. All in all, it is through above soft power, we can not only advertise our country's positions on global issues, but promote our image around the world. We strongly believe that with our young heart, we can have an impact and we can make a difference. Come on, everybody, let's be the bridge, be the change. We can surely make Taiwan put on the map. Thank you very much.
Day.接下来欢迎第五队上台。计时开始。
How can we make the world understand Taiwan better by increasing its soft power? Since the year 1971, when Taiwan withdrew from the United Nations, it has become the so-called unrecognized state. It has been excluded from many international organizations, including the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, also known as the UNFCCC, and the International Criminal Police Organization, Interpol. Though its political situation is so difficult, Taiwan steps up effort to raise its global profile. Soft power is one of the strategies that Taiwan adopts to pursue recognition on the global stage. And further on, my teammates Yixing, Laurie, and Holly will elaborate on three types of soft power that Taiwan possesses.
Yes. Thank you, Carol. For decades, Taiwan has been an electronic design hub, making components for some of the biggest technology in the world, like Philips and Apple. Now, besides being successful in the electronic design industry, Taiwan is creating its own brand in fashion industry as well. For instance, Dou Chengli is a designer's brand established by two Taiwanese, Dou and Chengli, whose first concept store, WOM, was chosen as one of the must-see tourist attractions in Louis Vuitton City Guide Taipei. In addition, it was chosen by the celebrities to attend international events. This year, the premiere of Golden Horse Film Festival, the 2014 Best Leading Actress in the Golden Horse Award, Chen Xiangqi, showed up wearing Dou Chengli. Another exciting sample is Seven Crash, shown on the runway of New York Fashion Week in February. It proudly declares a made in Taiwan spirit, featuring Taiwanese language rap and famous tourist attraction as background on the screen. Next, my teammate Larry will elaborate how the Taiwanese filmmakers bring Taiwan to the global stage.
Yes, thank you, Yixing. Many of the world's greatest film directors come from Taiwan. For example, Edward Yang, Hou Xiaoxian, and Cai Mingliang are leading filmmakers of the contemporary world. Edward Yang won the Best Director Award at the Cannes Film Festival for his film, Yi Yi. Hou Xiaoxian won the Golden Lion Award at the Venice Film Festival for his film, A City of Sadness. He also won the Best Director Award at the Cannes Film Festival in 2015 for his film, The Assassin. And Cai Mingliang has also played a significant role in the world cinema. Furthermore, a younger generation is also rising. Last month, Taiwanese director Zhao Deying took the Fediora Award for Best Film with his latest film, The Road to Mandalay. He gave his credit to Taiwan's liberal environment and the guidance and support of Taiwanese directors Ang Lee and Hou Xiaoxian. Besides, the Taiwanese government is also planning to build a large movie theater in Tainan, which could attract international film production projects. Then, it is certain that Taiwan will become an international film hub. And next, my teammate Holly will elaborate how, by providing humanitarian aid, Taiwan can attract other countries' attention.
Thank you, Laurie. Taiwan has been a provider of humanitarian assistance since 1985, when World Vision Taiwan launched a project called Bread of Love to deal with the famine in Africa. One example was the help given by Taiwanese people to the victims of the 2008 Sichuan earthquake. A total of $1.6 billion were raised, and rescue teams and medical professionals were sent to China to help with the relief effort. Also, Haiti, which was struck by a 7.0 magnitude earthquake in 2010, have benefited from Taiwan's humanitarian aid efforts. The Red Cross raised $1.6 million to facilitate the rebuilding of homes and the provision of volunteers. In addition, after the March 11th Japan earthquake, Taiwanese people provided up to $17 million NT dollars for the reconstruction effort, which made up a large percentage of the international donations made throughout the world. In addition, the World Vision Taiwan has been raising money for Haiti and Sri Lanka, which were both struck by serious floods and hurricanes. Taiwan has gathered the power of each individual and has become influential on an international scale. And now my teammate Carol will sum up the speech for you.
Yes, thank you, Holly. Taiwanese who have the opportunity to stand on the international stage, whether it is a catwalk on a fashion show or a red carpet in a film's awards ceremony, they all take the chance to promote Taiwan. Likewise, humanitarian assistance provided to countries like Japan and Haiti also helped Taiwan build long-term friendships with them. In the future, Taiwan is sure to attract attention with its famous brands, world-acclaimed films, and humanitarian assistance. And that brings us to the end of our speech. Thank you very much.
Thank you, 第五队。 接下来欢迎第六队上台。 计时开始。
In my leisure time, I always like to go to movies with my friends. To be honest, I really think that movies are the greatest invention in human history. Every time I see a movie, I always become immersed in the scenes, and it really inspired in me a lot of brilliant ideas. Honorable judges, ladies and gentlemen, Good morning. To my pleasant surprise, many of our local films, or ones which have been directed by our Taiwanese people, have broken box office records and have even become worldwide famous movies. As young diplomats, knowing that movie industry plays an essential role in Taiwan's soft power, we firmly believe that Taiwan should take advantage of our soft power, do more to promote it on the world stage, and make the world understand Taiwan better. Now, I would like to welcome my teammates to elaborate more on this topic. Nora, what do you think?
Thanks, James. As a Taiwanese person, using our advantages to make Taiwan stand out on the world stage is a considerable issue. Soft power comes in many forms, such as tourism, art, food, music. The list is practically endless. All of these can improve Taiwan's visibility. The movie industry is an aspect of the soft power of Taiwan, definitely worth mentioning. Although Taiwan's film industry is quite prosperous within Taiwan, we shouldn't be satisfied with that. We definitely have the talent to promote Taiwan's excellent films on the world stage. Next, Willow and Wilson will talk about two of our world's famous directors, Hou Hsiao-hsien and Li An, and spell out how they promoted Taiwan on the world stage in this manner. Willow?
Thanks, Nora. Many of you may recognize the name Hou Hsiao-hsien, a Taiwanese director. His works have been shortlisted for awards at the Cannes Film Festival 7 times, and his recent work, The Assassin, won the Best Director Award. Differing from mainstream movies, Hou doesn't attempt to make films with intricate plots or big summer blockbusters. Instead, he allows people to explore the beauty of our culture. Hou is very talented in cinematography, and his films are absolutely gorgeous. One of Hou's movies, A City of Sadness, is an excellent example of what I mean. The movie was shot at an old structure near Jiayi, surrounded by Taiwan's beautiful countryside. Without a doubt, showing the beauty of Taiwan to the world in this manner is a wonderful way to promote our country. Next, Wilson will give you another great example. Wilson?
Thanks, Willow. Another great example is Ann Lee. Ann Lee, who is probably Taiwan's best-known directors, makes movies full of plotlines and inspirations. He uses advanced technology to make his Oscar-winning films. For example, his latest movies, Billy Lynn's Long Halftime Walk, uses 3D cameras running at 120 frames per second with 4K resolution. This is the first movie that uses this technology. And, sure enough, it has become a big hit worldwide. Thanks to Ang Lee, not only has the world been introduced to Taiwan's cultural industrial strength, but also allows Taiwan's high-tech industry to shine brightly on the world stage. In addition to Billy Lin's Don't Have Time Walk, Ang Lee has also shot a film in Taiwan called The Life of Pi. There are many scenes in the movie that were filmed in Taiwan. The scenes were all filmed in the Taichung Water Park. The Mexican beach scene was shot in Canton. And even the animals in the movie, such as black bears, flamingos, and meerkats, were all provided by the Taipei Zoo. This not only greatly enhanced Taiwan's international popularity, but also allows Taiwan to shine brightly on the world stage. James?
Thank you, Wilner Wilson. Your examples are fantastic. I've heard of people saying that Hou Hsiao-hsien's work is like a poem. He's talented in cinematography and aims to explore the beauty of his scenes regardless of his mainstream appeal. And Lee, by contrast, is a more conventional director. He is good at combining the latest technology with his amazing stories. However different, both of them are the pride of Taiwan, successfully taking advantage of our soft power. We firmly believe that by utilizing our soft power, we can not only enhance our international visibility, but also strengthen our abilities in all kinds of aspects. They reflect all that is good about Taiwan and really deserves to be promoted on the world stage. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks for kind attention.
谢谢第六队。 接下来欢迎第七队上场。计时开始。
Taiwan is a free country that promotes creativity, innovation, and sharing of ideas. However, due to our political status, it can be challenging to raise our nation's profile. Our government has proposed the increasing of our soft power effort. Soft power is considered the second phase of power, which indirectly obtains desired outcomes without the use of physical force.A country's soft power is based on three resources, political values, foreign policy, and culture. So, how can Taiwanese youth contribute to the improvement of Taiwan's soft power? As young ambassadors, we would like to propose three different ways for youth to improve Taiwan's soft power.
Our first idea is to volunteer abroad.This summer, my classmate went to Bali as a volunteer to clean up beaches and assist local children in building and decorating the classrooms. She learned a great deal about Balinese culture. Local residents were extremely grateful for what they had done to help them improve their quality of life and achieve the dream for students studying in a clean, colorful classroom. In a second example, a group from our school went to Tanzania to help local residents build wells, bathrooms, and even a swing for young children to play on.The volunteers were shocked by the fact there was not enough water to take a bath. While they suffered, they pressed on helping locals in need. The Tanzanians were all thankful and appreciated what the volunteers had done to help them. We believe youth volunteering abroad is a soft power promoting Taiwan and our cultural influence. Taiwanese values such as cultural diversity and open-mindedness are generated through these actions.Kind-hearted and generous actions will always improve international relationships.
Our second way for increasing Taiwan's self-power is by holding the Model United Nations, MUN Conference. The MUN simulates the United Nations. It is a platform where students are assigned a country to represent and discuss international issues. Students who attend this mock conference.Have a better understanding of issues facing different countries, share information, and experience negotiations. As we learn more about the world, we are better equipped to understand cultural perspectives different than our own. We accumulate knowledge for communicating with our global partners. We believe that attending MUN is a great way to increase Taiwan's soft power. We not only understand different cultural perspectives and countries,We accumulate and develop knowledge and skills necessary to influence our international friends. As we take part in mock conference, we embrace the world and make international alliances and influence thinking. This, in turn, communicates our special political status, cultural values, and social ideals.
Our third plan in promoting Taiwan's soft power is by using the Fab Lab.The Fab Lab grew out of a popular class at MIT called How to Make Almost Anything. The Fab Lab promotes digital open learning with exchange of ideas between local makers and their global counterparts. The Fab Lab provides digital production tools such as 3D printers and laser cutters. Fab Labs are being adopted by schools around the world for project-based STEM education and are about creative thinking, innovation, and open-mindedness.These ideals go to the heart of what Taiwan believes in. Our school's Fab Lab gives students the opportunity to do hands-on learning, invent freely, and most importantly, work within a global community. While students are enjoying the moment, doing what they like, they create, innovate, learn from, and teach others around the world. Taiwanese success stories include prizes for the 3D printed designs at the International Invention and Innovation Exhibition.By working with a global community of makers, our youth possibly increase Taiwan's cultural influence with members of the Fab Lab community. And this is where the soft power of Fab Lab lays.
There are many ways to raise the world's awareness of Taiwan, share our values, and improve our international image. it is important to let the world recognize our significance. Volunteerism, cultural diversity and international engagement, and sharing innovative ideas. These are the values that Taiwan believes in. And as youth, we have a number of avenues through which to achieve these goals. Thank you for listening to what we think are three of the most accessible now.
谢谢第七队。 接着欢迎第八队上台。 计时开始。
Soft power, the ability to attract and persuade in a non-coercive way, and can be promoted with our cultural creativity. By boosting Taiwan's international image, it not only shows the world our advanced technology, but also our vibrant culture. Honorable judges, ladies and gentlemen, today we're going to present how we can utilize our soft power to make this world understand Taiwan better. First, my teammate Charmy would like to share with us the soft power Taiwan possesses and an outstanding Taiwanese. Charmy?
Thank you, Brian. Creativity is another virtue that Taiwan possesses, which contributes to our self-power. For example, He Peijing serves as a great paradigm by founding Taiwan Cultural and Creative Corporation in the town of Zhushan in Nantou County in 2010. He invited anyone with expertise in photography, painting, and film editing to help promote the town of Zhushan in exchange for a free night's stay in his hostel, Skyyard. Foreign visitors can experience the traditional bamboo craftsmanship, sample leaves, and stay at a renovated three-section compound building to appreciate the traditional existence. This project not only increased the foreigners' repeat business rate, but also transformed a small town into a popular tourist attraction. With the creative power of He Peijing, he not only carried out his dream, but successfully utilized Taiwan's soft power to make Taiwan shine on the international stage. What do you think, Iris?
Awesome. Zhou Tian folk drums and art troupe originally began as a traditional Taiwanese temple fair parade team. Over the years, they put their effort into artistry, performance, and localization. Gradually, they transformed themselves into an innovative and artistic group. Members of the team consist of teenagers who dropped out of high school, and with help from the troupe, teenagers were able to get back on track in life through performing as a team. As a result of their training, they express their youthful energy in their performances and are not only known as professional performers, but also as folk art experts. The story of this troupe was also adapted into a movie that garnered critical acclaim in Taiwan, and media outlets worldwide even reported on how fascinating the parades were. In 2002, Taiwanese Canadian Culture Society invited the Temple Fair Parade team to perform in Canada. The members of the troupe were all very thrilled to have the opportunity to convey Taiwan's traditional culture in a foreign country. Now it's your turn, Kyle.
Thank you, Iris. The earlier performances we saw today really showcases our Taiwan soft power, such as our education system and our extraordinary creativity. Also, holding exhibitions, trade shows, and joining competitions internationally are some effective ways for us to show our cultural creativity and to raise Taiwan's image around the world. Founded by Chen Yizhen in 2005, Grass Jelly Studio has become one of the best visual design teams in Asia. They cooperated with the Taipei government to film the Taipei Bit video and won the Red Dot Design Award for communication design. It highlighted Taiwan's brand new creations and over 40 sites related to cultural creativity, such as Yongle Textile Market, Chengpin Bookstore, and Huashan Creative Park. Amazingly, this video also entitled Taipei City
to take the honor of being the 2016 World Design Capital, which really can integrate our own culture to other parts of the world. As the studio utilizes its creativity and lets more people know about our own culture, they not only achieve their goals in making more extraordinary videos, but also tell the entire world that we, Taiwan, do stand out as one of the most sparkling jewels in this international family. Back to you, Brian.
Thanks, Kyle. From the aforementioned examples, we strongly encourage youth from all over Taiwan to realize that our culture is unique from others, and we can make the world understand Taiwan better by promoting our culture to the world. As the world becomes increasingly knowledgeable about Taiwan and our culture, our soft power can likewise disseminate internationally.
We have a great environment
with tremendous opportunities.
And with your help,
we can absolutely
immerse ourselves in the global community and make our future brighter than ever. Thank you.
谢谢第八队。 接下来欢迎第九队上台。 计时开始。
Hello, everyone. Due to Taiwan's special political status, the hard power we can use is limited in many aspects. But this won't stop us from promoting Taiwan. What we need is a power like water. As Lao Tzu said, nothing is softer or more flexible than water. Yet, nothing can resist it. Soft power is the water of Taiwan. Soft power is the ability to shape other preferences through appeal and attraction. And it gives Taiwan an opportunity to shine on the global stage by sharing our culture, food, high-quality tech, or even our people. Today, we will tell you what is Taiwan's soft power and how can we utilize them to make the world know Taiwan's better. Nina?
Thanks, Christine. Taiwan is famous for its technology industry. Let me ask you, how many of you are using the iPhone? Do you know that 80% of the part of an iPhone are made in Taiwan? Apple revealed that the Taiwanese company, Honghai Precision Industry, commonly known as Foxconn, owns assembly plants for iPhones and iPads. HTC Phone is a technology industry in Taiwan. Michael Qinglonglu, a former ambassador to France, introduced HTC Phone at France Enterprise's Oscar Awards show. All the audiences were stunned by the high-quality technology of HTC Phone. Like water, the soft power of Taiwan's high-quality technology can be flowed to the world, bringing life and refreshment. Through the persistent flowing of this soft power, a secure place for Taiwan in the world can be carved out. The above-mentioned examples is the proof of Taiwan's high-quality technology and can be one of the best soft power in Taiwan. Next, Vivian will introduce Taiwan's famous delicacy. Vivian.
Thanks, Mina. Another feature of Taiwan is our innovative cuisine. Today, I'm going to introduce our tasty national beverage, pearl milk tea. In the last 20 years, this tasty drink has spread all across the globe. The famous bubble milk tea store in London, Bubbleology, sells 500 to 600 cups of this drink every day. The founder has also added some other special ingredients in order to match the taste of foreigners. This innovative culinary creation has become successful worldwide, at the same time promoting Taiwan in a pragmatic way. Well, it might not seem like much, but food and drink can really be an important way to share our country's culture with others. We should seize the opportunity to use this soft power and increase our country's visibility. Next, Winnie will tell us more about how to promote our country through our unique culture. Winnie?
Thanks, Vivian. Water is an absolute necessity in people's everyday lives, much as the same way as people cannot live without culture. Taiwan is nowadays a multicultural society made of Taiwanese, Hakka groups, and Aborigines. We enjoy absorbing different kinds of cultures and have therefore developed Taiwan's own culture, which preserves the uniqueness of each, and while at the same time adapting and being adapted. But to use our soft culture as soft power, we have to promote it to the world. Undoubtedly, the Cloud Gate Dance Theater is one of a great representation for Taiwanese art. It is a world-renowned modern dance group that combines Taiwan's culture and tradition. As the founder Lin Huaiming said, "I consider Taiwan to be the crystallization of all its cultures." Obviously, the power of our ancient and evolving culture is undeniable. Using our culture as soft power, we will, just like water, flow into every corner of the world, bringing Taiwan to all its inhabitants. Back to you, Christine.
Thank you, Winnie. Just like water, one drop of water may not be effective, but over time, as more drop of water accumulate, it can carve rocks, shape canyons, and turn stone into sand. Promoting Taiwan through soft power is not only government's job, but citizens should also lend a hand in this effort. Day after day, the world will get to know Taiwan, this beautiful country, better. And the soft power of Taiwan will flow to every corner of the world. Thank you.
谢谢第九队。接下来欢迎第十队上台。计时开始。
Honorable judges, dear teachers, and fellow students, I'm Jasmine. Today, we would like to talk about some examples of Taiwan's soft power and how to use this soft power to raise our country's visibility. When it comes to France, the first thing flashing into our mind is the delicate cuisine, and Italy, exquisite fashion. Speaking of Japan,Sushi is the most striking thing that we would think of. How about Taiwan, our own country? With its modern and convenient cities, free and open political environment, and a vibrant and inclusive society, Taiwan has become known as a premier business, cultural, and tourist destination. Besides, Taiwanese people are known for their friendliness and hospitality.All of them are powers that made Taiwan more popular and refined. They are known as subpowers. Subpower comes from culture, value, and public opinions that make a country get its international support. Next, my teammate Joanne will give us some examples.
As mentioned above, we Taiwanese youth are sparing no effort to demonstrate soft power around the world.An amazing new design is one example. In fact, many Taiwanese students are devoting themselves to making the most of their imagination and design talent. Many of them have created original designs that have received a lot of attention and praise. For instance, Taiwanese students won awards in Red Dot almost every year. Also, we are reputed to be invincible in the IF Concept Award.In addition, another soft power that impresses me the most is the tug-of-war team from Jingmei Girls High School. Since 2010, when the Jingmei team won the 540-kilogram World Indoor Championship, they have won many awards. The high school team, now internationally acclaimed, went on to bag further world championships. This September,They have just arrived back from Sweden and won 2016 World Outdoor Tug-of-War Championship. Thus, it proves that young and inexperienced as we are, our efforts and creativity can still bring us to the global stage and expose Taiwan to the world successfully. Next, my teammate Christina will tell more.
As mentioned above, I would like to talk more about how can we do to promote Taiwan's soft power to the people around the world. To start with, making video and uploading on social networking website. Take ProMutic for example. A bunch of teenagers made a music video called Bo Ba Life, uploaded on YouTube, which shows Asian revolution and promotes the most famous beverage in Taiwan. Besides, a personal blog is also the good way to advertise our country's soft power. So, we can create our own blog to share the glorious moments when Jingmei Girl High School team won the 2016 World Tug of War Championship with 6 gold medals. Or, we can write down in a blog how Taiwanese youth won the international design competition and how foreigners feel amazed about that. In this way, I believe we can definitely promote Taiwan to the world. Next, my teammate Tiffany will conclude our speech.
As a global citizen, raising the visibility of our country is increasingly important. Developing soft power is one of the good ways to achieve it. In the past few years, Taiwan has put considerable effort into using soft power. It has gradually gained a good reputation in many countries. By participating in international sports competitions, we are able to display athletic excellence, just like Jingmei Girls High School students who won the World Championship of Tug of War in Sweden this September. By taking part in design contests such as Red Dot or IF Design held in Germany, Taiwanese youth are able to show their creativity and imagination. In addition, by posting videos related to our soft power on YouTube and our achievements on the blog, we can promote our unique culture and encourage foreigners to come check out Taiwan for themselves. With these achievements, we would definitely bring the notice of many other countries. As youth of Taiwan, we should be immensely proud of the progress that we have made and our ability to create a better tomorrow. Thank you very much.
Thank you, 第10队。接下来是我们的中场休息时间了，我们请所有的朋友们在2:35的时候回到我们的棚内，我们会2:40准时继续开始，谢谢。1 2 1 2 test test 1 2 3 1谢谢。接下来欢迎第11队上台。计时开始。
When the Berlin Wall came down, its collapse was not caused by a barrage of artillery, but by hammers and bulldozers wielded by people whose minds had been changed. In other words, the end of the Cold War was partly caused by soft power, said Joseph Nye, a Harvard University professor and the former dean of the John F. Kennedy School of Government.He is also the one scholar who coined the term soft power. Professor Joseph Nye defined soft power as the ability to affect others to get the outcomes that you want through attraction and persuasion instead of carrots and sticks. In an interview, he noted that if a country has a culture which is attractive to others, it may make other countries willing to hear its views.Or sympathize with its views. Based on this concept,
The one element that constitutes Taiwan's soft power is care for humanity. I can hardly imagine how Taiwan's care for those in need can help attract and persuade others to get the outcomes that we want. Now John is going to explain to you what has happened.
A Belgian couple came to Taiwan to assess whether Taiwan could be part of the Schengen visa waiver program. They were impressed by the unique night market culture, as well as delectable snacks. However, what fascinated them more was the MRT. Besides the convenience, they were amazed to see priority seats in each car, and stunned to learn that there are cars reserved exclusively for women at night. Such a policy to them is an indication of respect for those in need, which signifies that Taiwan is a respectable and humane country. With great pride, in 2010, Taiwanese passport holders were told visa waivers were approved and would enter into force in January 2011. Now, we no longer require visas to travel to the EU for short period stays. The inclusion of Taiwan in the Schengen visa waiver program is a sign of progress in Taiwan's relations with European countries. Just as the EU commissioner said, the full reciprocal visa waiver would give a boost to the already good relationship between Taiwan and the EU.
This visa-free privilege indeed symbolizes an important diplomatic accomplishment. Now I'm going to tell you another story about how caring for humanity persuaded others to sympathize with our views. In the wake of the March 11th earthquake and tsunami, Taiwan extended a helping hand to Japan, which surprised the Japanese. In addition to sending a rescue team and relief goods, Taiwan also donated relief funds to Japan, a total amount of 20 billion yen, the largest amount of any country in the world. According to the president of Eurasia 21 Research Institute, the outpouring of aid from Taiwan has further improved Japanese feelings toward Taiwan, 72% being relatively good and 19% being extremely good, with a combined total of 90%. He even suggested that Japan should join together with the United States and the European Union to help Taiwan win the place in the international organizations, like the World Health Organization.
Although this call for Taiwan's meaningful participation in international organizations has yet to be answered, Japan has reiterated that Taiwan is an important friend and that it will continue to advance bilateral ties with Taiwan. What is power? Power is the ability to affect others. What is soft power? In contrast to hard power, it is the ability to penetrate the Iron Curtain without resorting to the military strength. What is Taiwan's soft power? The components of Taiwan's soft power include the acclaimed healthcare system, creative industries, and entrepreneurship. The list goes on and on. However, I would like to conclude that care for humanity is the most powerful one. Like a water jet that can cut the diamond, care for humanity embodies the ability to shape Taiwan's global standing. Care for humanity is the soft power that
lights up Taiwan.
Thank you.
谢谢第十一队。接下来欢迎第十二队上场。计时开始。
Good afternoon, dear judges. Our topic is about Taiwan's soft power. The definition of soft power is an intangible attraction based on the ideals and principles a person values. It stands for how the person behaves at home and abroad. soft power is not nearly the same as influence. After all, influence can also rest on the hard power of threats or payments. A country may obtain the outcomes it wants in world politics because other countries admire its value, emulate its example, aspire to its level of openness and booming. Soft power is more than just persuasion or the ability to move people by argument, though that is an important part of it. On the contrary, it is the ability to attract, and attraction often leads to recognition. Soft power is our superpower. May the force be with us.
Leaders have to make crucial choices about the types of power that they use, says Joseph Samuel Nye Jr. The government of Taiwan makes efforts to enhance its image and solidify its position in the world wide via soft power. When it comes to the technological development, these widely acknowledged brands, such as Trend Micro and ASUS, have contributed substantially to boosting Taiwan's profile. As for food, the renowned Taiwanese restaurant, Ding Tai Fung, has put Taiwan on the international map with its mouth-watering delicacies. Additionally, Taiwan's presence in arts and cultural events is also vigorous, especially in Asia, where Taiwanese artists have considerable influence on films, music, and dance. Internationally, the Cloud Gate Dance Theater and Taiwanese directors like An Li and Wei Deshun have helped shape the image of Taiwan as a creative and dynamic island.
Agriculturally, the representative of local fishermen, Zhong Yingying, known as Koi Queen, successfully promotes the business of koi carp to Western market and has won 4 championships in Holland. She compares the looks of koi carp to the traditional Chinese paintings. The sales skills of koi carp with the distinguished oriental features are so superior that Taiwanese agriculture brings the notice of many other foreign countries, starting to shine every corner of the globe. In the past few years, Taiwan has spared no effort to actively engage in foreign assistance during natural disasters. For instance, in the wake of the earthquake Kumamoto in April this year, Taiwanese contributed generously to the relief of the grievous areas, and people in Japan really appreciate our selflessness. The bilateral relations have thus become much more closer ever since.
Ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country. Surely, we Taiwanese students are not bystanders. Besides admiring the examples above, we should also cultivate the ability of practicing the soft power to do a favor to our country. As the saying goes, the vision must be followed by the venture. It is not enough to stare up the steps, we must step up the stairs. There's no doubt that the world stage is crowded, but keep in mind that our potential is boundless. Soft power is the way we practice, a belief internalize, and get along with. Words persist, power persists, all efforts still persist. Hard power is there, and it will remain. But we can learn how to integrate hard power and soft power into smart power. In this way, Taiwan will be the next country ahead of time.
Thank you.
谢谢十二队。接下来欢迎第十三队上台。计时开始。
Five,
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. What comes up to your mind when you hear the power of a country? And there's more and more interconnected world. Influence is power. Joseph Nye, an initiator of the concept of soft power, argued that a soft power is due to the traditional foreign policy of carrot and stick, giving money using force. Flexible resources. Try to make them more internet connected to the world. Taiwan has been influenced by China factor, has no formal diplomatic relations with many countries, and does not enjoy the international membership of international organizations. To avoid from being isolated from the international society, our government has put a lot of effort on flexible approaches to persuade the audience around the world put more attention to Taiwan. Bessie, can you tell us some examples about how Taiwan gets a footing on the international society?
Absolutely. Thank you, Adam. BBC News commented that Taiwan's soft power raises profile. Taiwan has successfully raised its profile through building recognized brands, such as Giant, Din Tai Fung, and HTC Corps. Besides, Taiwan's presence in arts and cultural events is also strong, especially in Asia, where Taiwanese stars have significant influence in film, music, and TV. Internationally, the Cloud Gate Dance Theater, Minghua Yuan, and the Taiwanese film directors like An Li and Cai Mingliang have helped shape the image of Taiwan as a creative and dynamic place. The above example shed lights on the realization of the concept of locality globalized. These examples show that Taiwan not only does have the strength to build bands made in Taiwan, but also can market them to the world. Next, Aaron will tell us how our government is guiding us to cultivate our soft power.
Thank you, Bessie. Taiwan's government has chosen cultural and creativity, tourism, leisure, and environmental protection. As a result, Ministry of Culture was set up in 2012. Grants and loans are provided to the activities on these aspects. We may see international book fairs, independent bookstores, creative parks, cultural districts, and think tours are flourishing these days. The government's efforts are paying off if we look at the numbers of tourists. For example, I met some friends with Hong Kong people on their way to Canton. It's their second trip to Taiwan this year. I asked them why they love Taiwan. They told me they love Taiwan's fusion cuisine, green farming, exquisite gastries, and boutique hotels. Yan, could you tell me why Taiwan's soft power play is full of its role?
Indeed. Thank you, Ariel. With the rapid flow of information, we can often learn from international experiences and apply to our domestic policies. Public diplomacy among NGOs can be considered as another byproduct of a nation's soft power, because their work reflects a culture that encourages diversity and always conveys a far more convincing and compelling narrative than words. As one American diplomat once said, Taiwan has grown into a society that represents the most of our important values that we tried to promote in the world. Therefore, with the soft power, I believe that Taiwan has headed for and will grow into a society that can win appreciation and admiration from the world.
Bob, thank you.
谢谢13队。接下来欢迎14队上台。计时开始。
On a white glazed surface, a majestic dragon rises from clouds. Its claws reach out as if trying to seize the bright golden sun. This awe-inspiring image is cleverly embedded in a set of tableware, and it illustrates Taiwan's soft power. Ladies and gentlemen, today we would like to talk about the types of Taiwan soft power.And how we utilize them to make the world understand Taiwan better. According to Harvard professor Joseph Nye, soft power is the ability to attract and co-opt, in contrast to hard power, the ability to force and coerce. Taiwanese youth live up to the definition by merging traditions with unfailing innovation into something unique. On the other hand, we also help.People in other countries and spread our love to the world. With cultural creativity and humanitarianism as our strongest soft power, we Taiwanese youth can surely make the world understand Taiwan better. Up next, Ray would like to elaborate on a successful example.
Thank you, Andre. Jiang Zhengchen, a world-renowned Taiwanese chef,exemplifies how can we Taiwanese youth let the world understand more about Taiwan by utilizing cultural creativity, which is our strongest soft power. At the age of 20, he went to France out of his passion for cooking, where he made astonishing achievements, such as being head chef of a 3-star Michelin restaurant, and winning international accolades from Time magazine and many other authorities. In 2014,Jiang went back to Taiwan and opened a highly acclaimed restaurant called Raw. In Raw, our familiar Taiwanese dishes are turned into one-of-kind cuisine with Western culinary techniques Jiang mastered overseas and, fresh ingredients from local farms. Raw is selected as one of Asia's 50 best restaurants and draws gourmets from all around the world.The successful example of Jiang Zhengchen illustrates that with cultural creativity, we Taiwanese youth can surely increase foreigners' understanding of Taiwan.
Thank you, Ray. Aside from cultural creativity, humanitarianism is yet another soft power that we Taiwanese youth can utilize to make the world understand more about Taiwan. Take my brother as an example. Last summer, he joined a program called Reliable Working Group in Africa.Through the iYouth platform sponsored by the Ministry of Education. He went to Tanzania to teach children in the remote area. One day after class, he saw a little girl crying in her mother's arms, begging for a chance to go to school. "I really wish you could, but we just can't afford that," the mother replied. Upon hearing this, my brother felt the pain of that little girl. After he came back to Taiwan, he started to set up online platformsto provide educational resources to them. From then on, whenever children in Tanzania use the platform, they think of Taiwan and think of a country of love and humanity. What my brother has done is not simply an act of giving. He shows that we Taiwanese youth can use humanitarianism as our soft power to let the world know better about Taiwan. Next, my teammate Jason would like to give a conclusion to this topic.
Thank you, Kevin.With cultural creativity and humanitarianism, we Taiwanese youth can make the world understand Taiwan better. About 2,600 years ago, the influential Chinese philosopher Lao Tzu said, "Water is the softest thing, yet it can penetrate mountains and earth." Soft power, just like water, has the ability to overcome hardness.Taiwan might not be the biggest or most powerful country, but we are strong with our soft power.
Taiwan uses neither military force to owe other countries nor bankrolls to befriend them. We use cultural creativity and humanitarianism. By making good use of our soft power, we Taiwanese youth can successfully make the world understand Taiwan better and promote Taiwan to every corner of the planet. Thank you.
谢谢十四队，接下来欢迎十五队上台。计时开始。
Good afternoon. What is soft power? It is a term coined by Joseph Nye in the late 1980s. The opposite of hard power.Soft power is winning other countries' recognition, not through military and economic might, but through the use of positive attraction and persuasion to achieve the foreign policy objectives. Although hard power is important for many countries, what makes a country become more attractive and admirable is its unique customs, successful achievements in all fields, and the potential of local features.It is something intangible and immeasurable, but at the same time something being liked, respected, and trusted. In my opinion, Taiwan has great potential in the soft power of democracy. Though often mistaken for being under China's sovereignty, Taiwan is now pushing hard to strike out a more distinct international image with innovation sparking in the democratic society, which leads.To the world in harmony. Johnny, what do you think?
Thank you, Wendy. Well, in my opinion, I think Taiwanese love is one of our important soft powers. For example, Xia Yao Yi, a Taiwanese girl who won the first prize on Stanford Center Longevity Competition, a special table set was designed for her grandmother with Alzheimer's to eat by themselves as much as possible.This invention ended up benefiting many families suffering from this disease. Another story is Ji Zhengran, who is devoted to lighting up the city for the blind with the beam of light. When he's taking care of his hearing impaired father, he found out that the blind may have more difficulties walking around the city. So, with passion, he quitted his high-paying job as engineering and established the TH Light Company.To develop a new kind of GPS for the blind, which function as broadcasting for the blind wherever they go. So, these two inventions perfectly exemplified Taiwanese love and our caring in the global community. Next, Athena, can you please tell us more examples?
Thank you, Johnny. Culturally, with a free and diverse creative environment, Taiwan attracts560,000 visitors from home and abroad every year at the annual International Book Fair, providing an exchange platform for readers, writers, novelists, publishers, and experts in the world of cartoons, films, and other media. For those who are interested in Chinese culture and art, will surely be attracted to Taiwan by the soft power it displays.Such as an open academic atmosphere, a vast collection of historical materials, and a treasured house for the use and study of traditional Chinese characters. Fascinating, picture-like, ancient yet living, the traditional Chinese characters is not only a tool for us to commute, but also a cultural legacy that Taiwan receives, protects, and promotes proudly.To more impress the world, the Taiwan's government, as well as the private sectors, also promotes pop songs, films, and hit TV dramas to North America, Latin America, and Southeast Asia. Lastly, my teammate Jonathan will tell you more.
Thank you, Athena. Besides the annual Creative Expo, Taiwan spearheads development of country's cultural and creative industry while thrusting a local spirit of innovation, the global spotlight and showcases numerous offerings by exhibitors from more than 20 countries and help expand the global reach of Taiwan's soft power. All in all, with only limited resources, Taiwan will never be ignored and put to the sideline. Instead, with our soft power, we will continue to shine and share, amaze, and influence the world through the intangible and visible soft power. We believe the international relationship Taiwan cultivates with soft power will snowball, and the influences Taiwan wields will make the world spread the word about Taiwan. Lastly, only with active involvement can we make the world understand more about Taiwan, as is a goal of youth engagement strategy.
Yes, we can do better and reach further.
Thank you.
谢谢15队。接下来欢迎16队上台。计时开始。
Good afternoon, honorable judges and fellow contestants. Soft power is a concept first brought up by Joseph Nye of Harvard University, and it has been a heated issue worldwide. Instead of strengthening a country through hard power, which means by using military or economic measures, many countries strive to develop their soft power, which really raises their competitiveness and wins international recognition. As for Taiwan, its soft powers cannot be numbered or underestimated. Among them, my partners will share with you 3 aspects: the cultural industry, bioagriculture, and humanitarian relief.
Recently, Taiwan's cultural industries have been developing in full swing. Taiwan's creativity and taste are fully shown on artworks, music, movie, clothing, performances, and so on. One example that we have to elaborate on is Budai Shi and Pili International Multimedia. Budai Shi, also known as glove puppetry, is one of Taiwan's most important traditional cultural treasures. The wooden warriors in its shows, as well as the theme songs, are known to people of all ages. As for Pili International Multimedia, it successfully integrated traditional glove puppet with modern entertaining elements. In addition to its dedicated costumes and authentic Taiwanese dialogue, special visual and audio effects combined with pop music also helped make Pili shine brighter on the international stage. Since year 2000's blockbuster, Legend of the Sacred Stone, Pili has been showing the world that Taiwan has great power of cultural preservation and filming skills. In recent years, Pili has developed a wide variety of peripheral products. Its marketing strategy successfully appealed to not only Taiwanese, but also foreigners, thereby advertising Taiwan's unique culture to the whole world.
Bioagriculture is another soft power of Taiwan that we have been developing. Take more orchids, for example. Every year, its total amount in export orders received reaches about $200 million. Taiwan also won its bid to host the 23rd World Orchids Conference in 2020. The triennial event is the equivalent of Olympic Games of the orchid industry. The success of breeding the indigenous species shows that Taiwan's agricultural products are marketable and competitive on a global scale. Certainly, when it comes to agriculture, fruits are the major export products of Taiwan. To solve the problem of using pesticides, students of National Jiao Tong University apply the spider venoms as natural pesticides, combined with the use of monitoring apps. They grabbed 3 gold medals in the International Genetically Engineered Machine Contest with this winning device. We believe that with the application of this kind of smart and eco-friendly device, the plantation of fruits and crops will be more efficient, while food safety will be guaranteed.
As a world citizen, Taiwan showed great concern for international humanitarian crises. Every year, man-made and natural disasters causing immense suffering for innumerable people. Severe earthquakes and tsunamis ruined many people's homelands. Civil war in Syria has displaced more than 11 million people, 4 million of whom have become refugees. The world migrant in Europe is also the burning problem. Many charity groups in Taiwan, like Red Cross and Ciji Foundation, striving to provide life-saving assistance and long-term rehabilitation to disaster-affected communities. What they did is to support communities to become more resilient to future crises. Wherever there are people in need, there are passionate Taiwanese volunteers striving to bring hope to them. By practicing the spirit of humanitarianism to the world, other nations will have a better understanding of Taiwan's values and image.
As mentioned above, Taiwan possesses a variety of soft powers and is recognized by the world. Here's a very recent example. Just this year, Keeley International Multimedia collaborated with a famous playwright from Japan and created Thunderbolt Fantasy, a story written by the hands of a Japanese and brought to life by the hands of Taiwanese. The perfect finishing touch was added by a fabulous Japanese voice cast, which just goes to show how Taiwanese soft power is valued. These are what we youth should be proud of and do our utmost to carry forward. Thank you.
谢谢第16队。 接下来欢迎第17队上台。 计时开始。
Good afternoon to everyone in attendance here. The concept of soft power was introduced in the late 1980s by Harvard professor Joseph Nye. He stated that power is the ability to influence the behavior of others to get the outcomes you want. There are several ways one can achieve this. You can coerce them with threats or induce them with payments, which is considered hard power. Or you can attract and co-opt them to want what you want. This is soft power, and it is considered the second phase of power that indirectly allows you to obtain the outcomes you want. However, Nye also noted that soft power is not necessarily a good thing. Hitler, Stalin, and Mao all possessed a great deal of soft power in the eyes of their acolytes, but that did not make it good. It is not necessarily better to twist minds than to twist arms. Now, Hank will offer some further thoughts.
Thank you, Angela. So, what exactly is soft power? The currency of soft power is culture, political values, and foreign policies. According to some 2015 rankings, the United Kingdom currently holds the top spot in soft power. English is the international language. Many countries use the British form of democracy and government. British media is broadcast internationally, notably the BBC World Service and BBC World News. Schools and universities in Britain are popular destinations for students of other nations. On the other hand, the other countries consistently rank highly for soft power. The United States is possibly facing a steep decline in its soft power if the incoming administrations follow through on all of its promised policies. But now, we will turn our attention to our home, Taiwan, and what soft power means for the country. Here, Howard will continue on with our speech.
Thank you, Hank. Like the rest of Asia, Taiwan is seeking a new role as it faces the rising economic power of the mainland. However, due to its relationship with China, Taiwan has limited options on a diplomatic level. Therefore, the use of soft power has become extremely important. Economically, in the last 50 years, Taiwan has transformed itself from a poor agricultural economy into a knowledge-based, high-tech economy. Politically, has seen a lifting of martial law, legalization of political parties, and freedom of press and assembly. In 2000, Taiwan peacefully transferred power from a 50-year-long rule by one party to another through an open democratic election. Soft power rather than hard power created Taiwan's democratic miracle. Internationally, Taiwan has maintained over 50 years of peace with its neighbors in a region plagued by bloodshed and warfare. Now, finally, Jessica will offer our concluding thoughts.
Thank you, Howard. Admirable as these achievements are, it is in the field of culture that Taiwan's current efforts are directed. The government in Taipei has chosen to raise the nation's profile through culture and creativity, including books, films, museums, performing arts, design, and tourism. The book strategy is reflected in Taiwan's hugely successful annual six-day International Book Fair in February. Another indication of Taiwan's attraction is its rapid rise in the number of Hong Kong students coming here. In 2015, the number was 700% higher than 4 years previously. In an era when it has lost many of the industries that drove the economy during the past 50 years. As one of Asia's four original tigers, many believe this is the way forward for Taiwan to define its place in the world. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, 第17队. 接下来欢迎第18队上台。 计时开始。
What is soft power? Well, this concept was first invented by Joseph Nye, who defined with a definition, applying power by persuasion and attraction rather than military forces. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. According to the 2016 International Expat Insider Survey, Taiwan is the top one country in the world that expatriates choose to live in, with Germany ranking 17 and Hong Kong ranking 44. Also, the number of Hong Kong people moving to Taiwan in 2014 was 7,500, which was 3 times of the number in 2011. In terms of technology, Taiwan is not as powerful as Germany. And as for GDP, Taiwan ranks 17 and Hong Kong ranks 6 in the world. Then, what on earth leads to the amazing result of the top one country in the world that expatriates choose to live in? Well, the answer lies not on hard powers such as technology or GDP, but in soft powers. Now we have this brand new definition for soft power. We can define it by four words. S for selfless, O for open-minded, F for free, and C for true. Later, Peggy and Eileen will tell us about how can we use soft power to influence the world. Let's welcome Peggy.
Thank you, Annie. In the first place, people in Taiwan are selfless and always willing to help. Last month, our school went to Minamisariku in Japan, where the local people treated us like their own family and continue saying thanks to us. Because when the tsunami attacked Minamisariku in 2011, the whole city was destroyed and thousands of people were killed. However, we provided not only donation for them to rebuild their hometown, but also sincere concern from the bottom of our heart. Taiwanese are selfless, helping many people in need around the world. And therefore, we are welcomed by the most countries in the world. Thus, we enjoy 153 countries visa-free or visa on arrival access. It is the proof of Taiwan's soft power. Now, let's welcome Eileen.
Thank you, Peggy. In addition to being selfless, Taiwanese are also open-minded to all kinds of culture. In Taiwan, we can enjoy Taiwanese culture, Aboriginal culture, Hakka culture, Japanese and Western culture, and most important of all, authentic Chinese culture. After the Cultural Revolution happening in China in the 1960s, many precious Chinese cultures were destroyed. However, Taiwan still maintains the traditional Chinese characters and values, such as loyalty, honesty, piety, and modesty. Based on the rich heritage and legacy, Taiwan becomes a very creative and attractive country, appealing to more and more tourists coming to Taiwan. According to the Tourism Bureau, the number of tourists coming to Taiwan in 2005 is 3.3 million and expands to 10 million in the year of 2015. That is, during the 10 years, the number of tourists coming to Taiwan has been growing triple. Now, let's welcome Bonnie to introduce the rest of the letters for us.
Taiwan is a free and domestic country. We can say the things in our mind publicly out loud. That is free. And as for true, we say the things in the bottom of our heart without holding back anything. Last month, our school journal club went to Hong Kong to interview two film directors of the Hong Kong film, 10 Years. And during the interview, they told us that the most precious soft power that we own is free and true. How can we use soft power to let more people in the world understand Taiwan? Well, Taiwan is eager to build diplomatic relations with many countries, especially our nearby neighbor countries in Southeast Asia. We can use these soft power to build a friendlier relations with these countries. Ladies?
Thank you.
谢谢第18队。 我们第二阶段的英语即席演讲比赛到这里告一个段落了，哇，每一个同学都表现得超好的耶，等一下评审老师应该会有点伤脑筋咯。接下来呢，马上就要进行的是我们今天比赛的最后一个阶段了，益智问答，究竟哪一个队伍可以把前三名抱回家呢？让我们拭目以待。 第二阶段的英语即席演讲比赛到这里告一个段落了，哇，每一个学生都表现得超好的，等一下评审老师应该会伤脑筋了。接下来马上要进入的就是我们今天的最后一个阶段益智问答比赛了，究竟哪些队伍可以把前三名抱回家呢？让我们拭目以待。